Hey man, I just want to let y'all know that I will be reacting to Eminem's full Music to Be Murdered by Side B. I have already reacted to the full Side A. So y'all make sure I go check out all of those reactions for sure. They are all up on my channel. I've also re or already reacted to Alfred, the intro, Black Magic, Alfred's theme, Tone Deaf, Book of Rhymes, and that. So y'all make sure I go check out those too.
What's good, it's your boy Montana 300, man. Rap God, FG shit, man. Shout out to World Class Lifestyle. You already know what it is, man. Squad.
You must be stupid if you got a rapper in mind that you pick over me like a caption. Sauce on them, get him a napkin. I'm gonna snap like Sebastian. I'm out this world, I'm galactic. I'm talking different, no accent.
What up, y'all? Welcome back to World Class Lifestyle. And today we are reacting to Eminem featuring Ty Dolla Sign. Favorite bitch, the official audio. Let's get straight to it. You know, I woke up this morning. Well, I didn't wake up this morning, but I just woke up, had reactions already getting ready to get posted and shit. Just posted another one, so y'all make sure I go check those out. And I looked at my comments. I appreciate my two guys for helping me out in the comment section, all like breaking down all of the bars that I missed and shit like that. I catch more than I miss. I can say that. But another thing I do want to say is I don't know where my head was right. I know what a fucking, my boy Kenneth K, he's the one who posted this comment. He said an acronym. My dumb ass says something about a fucking acronym is the opposite of, that's an antonym, you dumb ass. Like, I woke up, looked at my phone, and I was like, acronym. I don't know. I was probably not in the right headspace, but I was like, you, NBA, like the acronym. He told me that he's broken down acronym is NBA. All right, I'm for the press play. Fuck.
Nah, for real.
Thank
you know
you,
what I'm saying? Like,
fuck.
Like, music my first love, right? But what it turned into is like, you know, these cats got it now. She just like a hoe.
She ain't doing it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Real.
Yeah.
Switch it up and everybody changed and shit on it.
Yeah, everybody done ran through it. Mumble rap.
Ain't no more substance and shit, right?
Don't treat it the way it needs to be treated.
I kind of want that.
I was young, I was hungry, I was chasing the bag. At 21, I was lucky to find an uneaten fucking honey bun. I forgot about now, I got money falling out. 50s, 100s, and 20s, and I know nothing is funny about the Manchester bombing, but we got something in common. Both of us are alarming. Found this.
See, think I'm missing some shit already.
Honey bun, I forgot about now, I got money
falling. He said honey bun, first of all. Y'all know my motherfucking shit. You got me fucked up, nigga. I'm the honey bun. I got plenty more up in here. Honey buns, my nigga. Look, listen. 20 more honey buns up here.
Falling out 50s, 100s, and 20s. And I know nothing is funny about the Manchester bombing.
Oh, and I know nothing is funny about the Manchester bombing. Okay, he's addressing that. Because the lyrics he said in one of his other songs.
But we got something in common. What? Both of us are alarming. Foul, disgusting.
Both of us are alarming. Okay, now Kendrick said. That's why you're supposed to let the scheme play out. I be forgetting shit. This is why I can't let the shit play out, but hold on.
About the Manchester bombing, but we got something in common. What? Both of us are alarming, foul, disgusting, and awful. So yeah. Repugnant and ugly. I could give the bus a marathon a run for its money. Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to have to pause it there because I think he's done. Okay. He pretty much said, okay, I can get, first of all, he said, I can get a Boston Marathon a run for its money. Boston Marathon. Didn't something happen at the Boston Marathon too? Like, if it didn't, then God forbid. But I do remember something. I think it was something that happened there. But he said, I can give the Boston Marathon a run for his money. Okay, Boston Marathon, that's where you running and shit like that. And then he said, me in the Manchester bombing, he ain't trying to, you know, make fun of it and shit like that. At least I think he did say something. He said something about some bomb that went off and shit like that. And it fucked up a lot of people and made a lot of people mad and shit. But he said, I ain't trying to make fun of it, but both of us are alarming. Foul, disgusting, and he's nasty, all that shit. He was talking about himself and the bombing, because this shit was shit cut. Okay.
Yeah, and you could say I'm a little bit immature, but this type of literature got me a little richer. But I get.
Ooh, I like how he. Ooh, dog. This thing. The way he. Like I said, he's the lyrical god. Ain't nobody fucking with him. The way he just played with that shit right there, this nigga just fucking said.
Say I'm a little bit immature.
I must say I am a bit immature, but this literature. Made me a little richer, like literature, like his words and shit like that, the literature, and the literature made him a little richer. Like, come on, the way he just
could give the bust a marathon a run for its money. Yeah, and you could say I'm a little bit immature, but this type of literature got me a little richer. But I get insecure when them other dudes hit on you, girl. You're letting them fiddle with your clitoris. Remember, you were
used to be my favorite bitch.
I knew he was gonna come on singing and shit.
Got me a little richer, but I get insecure when them other dudes hit on you, girl. You're letting them fiddle with your clitoris. Remember, you were
used to be my favorite. Yeah,
fiddle with
things will never be the same. Ain't it funny how you changed up and flipped the script? You don't let a bunch of lanes fall through and go play that I can't. You ain't have to do it like that. Told you I'll be right back. Look what you did, I need a new chick. Like the music, I had to bounce on my favorite.
Always hated my smile, mama told me it's goofy. I'd get picked on at school, come home and she'd school me. She never shook.
Smile, is that a little shot to Goofy? The, you know, that nigga. I think that's how he laughed and shit like that. Is that Goofy's smile? He always smiling and shit.
Mama told me it's goofy. I'd get picked on at school, come home and she'd school me. She never sugarcoated it to me. She said if I wasn't so stupid and ugly, I wouldn't always get bullied. I think of my struggles and get emotional. Could be because I'm behind the eight ball and far in the hole that they put me in.
Could be because I could hide behind the eight ball and fall in the hole that they put me in. Like eight ball, what's the shit called? Is it called pool? I think the shit where you get the stick, and I played it one time in my life, I think, with the actual shit. But it's a game on iPhone. I remember everybody used to play that shit, 8-ball. So, yeah, fall in a hole. It's the little holes and shit. I think it's called pool, yeah.
I'm on a roll like a tootsie. I'm just trolling you pussies, but I'm the 8-ball and far enough.
I'm on a roll like a tootsie roll. Okay.
Hold that they put me. I'm on a roll like a tootsie. I'm just trolling you pussies, but I'm like a stroller, because you'll see just how I roll if you push me.
I'm like a stroller, because I'll see. Because you'll see just how I will roll if you push me. Strollers, they get the rolling whenever they are pushed. And he said, hey, I'm going to get on a roll if you push me. Don't fucking play with me.
Like a tootsie, I'm just trolling you pussies. But I'm like a stroller because you'll see just how I roll if you push me.
But that's what I do this music for. When I was going through some of the hardest times, I drew from her. But she's like the devil because I just can't let loose of her. Cause the
She's kind of like the devil because I can't let Lucifer. Now, Lucifer is the devil. Go check out that TV show, Lucifer. That shit hit on Netflix. But real shit, though. The devil is Lucifer. And he said, I just can't let Lucifer. Like, I can't let her loose. I can't let her loose. Like, I feel the vibes, my nigga, but I can't let her loose. You know what I'm saying? And he said, I can't let Lucifer. Lucifer? Come on, bro.
See just how I roll if you push me.
But that's what I do this music for. When I was going through some of the hardest times, I drew from her. But she's like the devil, cause I just can't let loose of her. Cause the thought of losing her makes me wanna just let loose of her. Then I hit the studio and let loose of her. Cause the thought of losing her makes me wanna just let loose of her. Then I hit the studio, find a rendezvous with her.
Tell her it's a butt dial girl, yeah, booty call.
So it's a butt dial girl, yeah, booty call. So, hey, a butt dial. He did. He said something about a butt dial to one of his other songs. I forgot what it was. But he said, tell her it's just a butt dial, girl. Yeah, booty call. So he said, hey, I'm just calling you up to, you know, hit those. And then booty call is an actual butt dial. Like you butt dialing this shit, okay?
Studio, find a rendezvous with her.
Tell her it's a butt dial, girl. Yeah, booty call. That's how it used to be. Because you and me, we rule the world. And we make Curtis blow. Fuck, I miss them days. It used to be, cause you and me, we ruled the world, and we make Curtis blow. Fuck, I missed them days.
Damn, why you doing that? Why you? I fuck with 50 Cent. Have you ever seen the show Power? That's one of the top five shows all time. Have you ever seen the show Power? Why he just do that? He said, cause we the one who made Curtis blow. We made Curtis blow. Is that true? 50 Cent? And then I heard him say 50 in the background. Curtis, what is that? Curtis, I don't want to even try to say his last name because I forgot. Curtis Jett. Was I almost right? No.
It used to be, cause you and me, we ruled the world, and we make Curtis blow. Fuck, I miss them days.
He used to be my favorite. Yes, things will never be the same. Ain't it funny how you change up and flip the script? You don't let a bunch of lanes fall through and go playing that I can't permit. You ain't have to do. Like that, told you I'll be right back. What you did, I need a new chick. Like the music, I had to bounce on my favorite bitch.
You fucking leaving me, bitch? I don't think so. Sit your motherfucking ass down. I swear to God, you run to that door, I'ma put one in the back of your fucking head.
God damn.
And I'ma ask you this one time. The answer better be yes.
Would you marry me? Now that everything has changed, yeah, it'll never be the same as the era whence we came. From Nas to Pac, Ra, yeah. Eric B, and Kane. But I know a few from this era that are lyrically insane. And although most are never gonna hit the level Cole Louise at, or be emotionally attached to your...
Okay. I like that, He just said, now they will never... Hold on.
From Nas to Pac, Ra, yeah. Eric B, and Kane. But I know a few from this era that are lyrically insane. And although...
Okay, so he said, I know a few of those guys that are lyrically insane. And then he said they will, although they are lyrically insane, but he said they will never reach where Wayne and Cole is at. Now, Lil Wayne, okay, I understand. J. Cole, look, I don't know. Y'all tell me. When y'all listen to J. Cole, whenever I listen to J. Cole, yeah, J. Cole be having bars and shit like that. But Eminem, why don't you, I don't know. Eminem should know that he's number one. Then it's Lil Wayne. I don't even have J. Cole in my top five lyricists, like lyricists. No. But I don't know. Maybe it's because he got a lot of respect for J. Cole or something like that. Do y'all got J. Cole in y'all top five, like lyricists? Like, because J. Cole, he can. When I say lyricists, I'm saying metaphors, bars, similes. I ain't talking about like, oh, he know how to put words together. I'm talking about, oh. Wordplay too, all types of shit. Like whenever you able to make a nigga think and there's double meanings, all types of shit, triple meanings, double entendres, all entendres, all of that shit. Y'all got J. Cole? I don't. Me personally, I don't. Cause it's so many, like, bro. I don't know, but maybe it's just the respect he got for J. Cole. I'm not sure.
Pac, Ra, yeah. Eric B, and Kane. But I know a few from this era that are lyrically insane. And although most are never gonna hit the level Cole Louise at, or be emotionally attached to your MTV raps. Yeah. Running home from school to catch an episode. The feeling that it gave you to rip the plastic off the tape you hold and peel it back. Yeah, tear it off and play it. What? Swear to God, 4 o'clock. We cried around the TV, butter in his. Underwear and socks when Nani was con artist and Poof had his hair and locks. Yeah, back when Flavor Flav had us wearing clocks. Went back with Ed Lover and there was two Dr. Dre's. That's a paradox.
And it was two Dr. Dre's. That's a paradox. So, pair of doctors, Dr. Dre's, two doctors and shit like that, two Dr. Dre's. But he just reminiscing right now.
Went back with Ed Lover, and there was two Dr. Dre's. That's a paradox. But I never thought I'd get so jealous at the thought of letting you go. Psychologically, it's gonna bother me. My eyes are already watery. Part of me don't wanna stop till I get you back. If I gotta put the work in and tell you I'm never giving this up. Other part wants to tell you just to get fucked. Go back to whatever dick that you suck. Get back together with them, you slut. Giving up the vagina like a trip to the gyna. Kinda just wanna.
Ooh, giving up the vagina just like a trip to the gyna. See, I'm like, probably like. Before I took my little nappy nut, I probably would have missed that line. I'm like, what the fuck is he talking about? A gynecologist. It's there. Like, I don't know. Like I said, I don't know if I was, like, in a wrong headspace. I don't know what the fuck it was. But I when I seen Kenneth K explain it to me what a fucking acronym was, I was like, you what the fuck are you, like, what was you on? That wasn't a world-class lifestyle. That wasn't me. I don't know who the fuck that was. We got to make an alter ego for that nigga, because that's that, I don't know. That's that don't feel like reacting world-class lifestyle. That's what the fuck that was. When I see you got to explain to me what the fuck a guy did. Like, I was disappointed in myself. I was like, God damn. But, damn, that shit hurt. But yeah, giving up the vagina, like a trip to the gynecologist, they like check the pussy or some shit like that. I don't know what they do at it. I just know it has something to do with the, you know, with the pussy. And he said, you was giving it up to all these niggas. Like, damn.
Dick that you suck, get back together with them, you slut, giving up the vagina, like a trip to the gynecologist, when I helped you become bigger than you were, but I guess it has slipped your mind, you must be biding your time, looking for someone to come along that'll make you feel like I did back when you were mine, huh?
Damn.
But truthfully, it was never really you and me exclusively, and there's too many new MCs you can choose between, but no matter how many motherfuckers ran through it, they can't do it like me, but I can't keep burning.
Hey, I like what he doing, because I know he's talking about rap, hip-hop, he's talking about rapping hip-hop and shit, like this, in this song and shit, so... I like how he doing this, because he's saying, like, hey, no matter how many people done ran through you, no matter how many people done shit had their chance with you, you know ain't nobody did it like me. Talk your shit, my nigga.
Too many new MCs you can choose between, but no matter how many motherfuckers ran through it, they can't do it like me, but I can't keep burning the candle at both ends, and I can't handle it when I leave and you find another.
Hey, he said, I can't keep on burning the candle at both ends, I can't do it here and then do it here. I can't keep doing that.
Motherfuckers ran through it, they can't do it like me, but I can't keep burning the candle at both ends, and I can't handle it when I leave and you find another one. Now I gotta take this beat and dismantle it. I won't breathe when I kill you, but if I can't have you, bitch, nobody can have me.
I won't breathe when I kill you, but if I can't have you, then nobody will. Damn, we gonna kill in a rap game.
Another one, now I gotta take this beat and dismantle it. I won't breathe when I kill you, but if I can't have you, bitch, nobody can have me. I used to be your favorite bitch.
I used to be your favorite bitch. And then the song end and shit. I like that. Hey, man. Shit. I enjoyed that one right there. Eminem, I like whenever he do that. I've been noticing that he's been doing that a lot. Like, I first heard it. I'm pretty sure he had did it before. Like, where he had speak on, like, one thing. I'm pretty sure he has done it before. But me not paying attention as much and just rapping the lyrics and shit like that, I really didn't notice. I think it was In Too Deep. Or it was the song where he had, like, did that. Or was it Never Love Again? I don't know. It was one of them songs where he like rapped and he made it seem like he was talking about a girl. But then at the end of the entire thing, he was talking about the pills. But you can still relate it to a female. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, I like whenever he do that, he takes it and he makes us think like, oh, he's talking about this. But then he really talking about this. But it can be, you know, related into both shits. So I like that. He was talking about rap and a female in this shit, you know, because the way how he was talking, like, hey, you let a nigga go suck some dicks, you was getting ran through by the whole squad, you know, so, I don't know, that's why I enjoyed this, you know, Cap, if y'all enjoyed this video, please make sure I hit that like button, comment down below, which I rate this song at a 10, this is Infinity out of Infinity, Ty Dolla $ign, he did his thing with his singing eyes, Eminem, he did his thing, like, as always, bro, he just be going crazy, spazzing out, Infinity out of Infinity for sure. The next reaction we got is Guns Blazing, so y'all make sure y'all stay tuned for that. Check out all these reactions over here to the side, because those are all of the reactions, well, those are a lot of the reactions that I got from Eminem on my channel. I got 20 plus Eminem reactions on my channel, so y'all make sure y'all go check those out. I got a special message for y'all. Hi there. God damn, if I wanted to play, it's gonna play right now though. Hi there. Would you want this dumbass nigga to react to any song that you want? Well, he charges $5 for any random song and $10 for personal music. So make sure y'all know that. Continue dancing, bitch nigga. Share all of my videos and don't be stingy. And please make sure I hit that subscribe button plus the bell so y'all get notified every single time I drop a video. Check out my new song. It's up above. If it's not up above, then it is the first link in the description. Thanks for watching.
Up, down, left, right, A, B, G, code. Pull up my gun, sing like Lee Show. Rick going to my coat, no superhero. BBS, my wrist like Sub-Zero.